Sport has the power to change lives, and today we're celebrating the beginning of Indigenous Football Week, when the football community comes together to support inclusion, cultural recognition and diversity.
And this morning, the John Moriarty Foundation is hosting a charity tournament to raise funds for their incredible football team, and our very own T-Mac has jetted off down the road to Allianz Stadium. It's his happy place, the football pitch.
Yes.
G'day, mate. What's happening where you are?
Hello, guys. Yes, I'm here in Allianz Arena. I feel like I live here these days. It's fantastic. It's such a special week in the football calendar in that it's Indigenous Football Week. And I'm joined now. I'm very proud to be able to meet John Moriarty here beside me. I'd just like to say thank you so much for everything that you do, not just in the past, but for the future of football and people's lives here in this country. Why don't you tell us a little bit about Indigenous Football Week and why it's so important?
Thank you. Well, we set up Indigenous Football Week, Roz and I, with our little business. And we support the whole team, the Aboriginal programs that we've got. And Indigenous Football Week is there to celebrate for us. And hopefully we'll expand with all the kids that we've got playing in. And we train in New South Wales, Queensland, Northern Territory. We hope to expand all that program. But for those kids, as we have with Shay, she's one of our kids from Borroloola, one of our relatives, she started soccer up there. And of course, she's achieved so much, and we can tell you a little bit more about what she's achieved. It's great for the team, for the kids, and for our program, for John Moriarty Football.
Most definitely is. They say you can't be what you can't see. John was the very first Indigenous man to ever play for Australia, and he's changing the whole aspect of football in this country. It's fantastic with the John Moriarty Foundation. We're going to meet Roz Moriarty now, who's also a co-founder of the John Moriarty Foundation. Roz, why don't you tell us about the great work that you guys do?
Yeah, thanks, Tristan. It's a really exciting day to see everybody here. We're really grateful. The theme of this year's Indigenous Football Week is Maya Mantra, a word from the Yanru language from our family community, John's community, Shay's community in Borroloola, which means partnerships. So we're celebrating all the partners who've helped us over the last 10 years to deliver football for good. So this is about a holistic football program. It's all about kids attending school, about healthier outcomes for them, 22 schools, 19 communities, our 60-strong staffing coach, our team here in Sydney. I mean, they're the real heroes of today who are out there delivering every day to make changes in lives for 10 years now, and the 7th edition of Indigenous Football Week. So our first Corporate Cup, we couldn't be more excited.
You could be more excited. You could be as excited as I am, because it's fantastic. And like I said, it's going to be celebrated everywhere in Australia, from Cooper Stadium down in Adelaide to Suncorp up in Brisbane. Shay Evans here is the inaugural scholarship holder from the John Moriarty Foundation. Shay, how important are stuff like this, like John Moriarty Foundation, for you?
Yeah, for me, it's very important, you know, to be able to have like Indigenous programs such as Moriarty Foundation. You know, it's a great initiative for Indigenous kids to come through program and, you know, be given the opportunity to explore what football can do.
You're from the same town as John. You went through the same pathway in that you went to Adelaide. You're back now at Sydney FC. You've got a World Cup on the horizon here in our country as well. Do you have any eyes on going to being part of the Matilda squad coming up for the new World Cup?
You know, I think, you know, being able to come through the program as well and develop my football, you know, to see where I've taken it and where I've come, you know, to see where I am today. It's been such a great journey, and, you know, hopefully, you know, can somehow fight for the spot or somehow get myself out there, yeah.
And you should, and you're great, and I hope you do great. I just hope you don't beat Ireland. It's the first game of the World Cup, it is. I'm part of the team here today. We've got the Paramount Plus team behind us here. You may recognise some of the faces. Some of them used to be professional footballers. Some of them... Fantastic day here today. Have you got any more thoughts on what's happening today, John? And just, again, I'm just so proud to meet you.
Look, thank you very much. We're very happy to be here. And, of course, we'd like to... develop our program for the kids and give Aboriginal kids an opportunity to achieve their goals. And through the game, what can you go? You can go anywhere in the world once you've achieved certain levels. And we hope that that will happen to our kids today. And when we set up the program, Roz and I, what we want to do is make sure that the kids have an opportunity. It was Roz that woke up early one morning and said, we've got to develop our program. And I said, go back to sleep. And that's when it started. So,
and Shay's just off a plane from Germany this morning. And we're just thrilled with how Shay is such a role model to all our kids and, you know, all these teams here today, nine teams who come out for the Corporate Cup to support journeys that the kids want to follow in Shay's footsteps. And, you know, it's just a fantastic day.
It really is. Everyone deserves to start from an even playing field. And because of the John Moriarty Foundation, they can. Guys, it's going to be a great day. It's going to be a great week and hopefully a great season. Take care.
Oh, Tristan, I can feel your excitement. When you talk about legacy, it doesn't get much better than John Moriarty. So thank you so much. And congratulations, Shay. Matilda, yeah, in the future, no doubt. Thanks, Tristan.